गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट. कीपिंग इन माइंड द पेस ऑफ टाइम, वी हैव डिडक्टेड फ्यू ऑफ योर चैप्टर फ्रॉम द बुक ड्रीम कैचर. सो नाउ लेट स्टार्ट विद द फोर्थ वन, दैट इज टू सीलिया. द टू सीलिया इज रिटन बाय पोएट बेन जॉनसन. हिज फुल नेम इज बेंजामिन जॉनसन. गो थ्रू इट दिस लाइन्स. These are the description of poet. Okay. They are the two stanza of the poem. I'll deal today only the first stanza. I'll deal line by line. So please pay attention. Drink to me only with thine eyes, and I will please with mine. There are the few words in the poem which is generally not used in general English, like thine, thou, Jove's and all. I'll tell you the meaning. Drink to me only with thine eyes. Here thine mean is your. The poet says that the poet express his feeling to his beloved one. He says that express your love. He says to that lady whom he love a lot, express your love by your beautiful eyes. He will see. He says that either you expresses your love or I will look at your eyes and feel the feeling what you are having for me. Further, the poet is saying that he is very anxious to know what that lady has having the feeling. He is very anxious to know all these things about himself, what that lady is feeling about him. At the same time, now the second line, and I pleased with mine. Here that this line means that if she expresses her love for him, then he pleased. Pleased means promise. He pleased to express his own love for her. Now moving to the next line, or leave a kiss but in a cup, and I will not look for a wine. By these lines, poet wanna say that if his beloved one leave a mark of kiss in any cup, if his beloved one gives a kiss on any cup, then he would have it. The poet will have that cup, and that cup on which that kiss mark is there, then in that cup wine isn't needed. Here poet compare the kiss mark of that beloved one to the wine. He says that, he expresses that, means that kiss is doing the work of wine over there. Poet is comparing. As I have told you, the poet is comparing the wine's intoxicating power with the kiss mark on the cup. Poet is saying how much intoxicating power a wine has to make anyone hangover. That same power, that same feeling, that kiss is also giving to him when he is having that cup, in which the cup, that kiss mark is there. So moving to the next line, the thirst that from the soul doth rise, doth ask a drink divine. Here the doth means does. For the poet is expressing that he wanted her to love, or he has a thirst of love. Poet has a thirst of love. Here the thirst of love doesn't mean the physical love. It's not limited to only to that love, but here his love is, he has compared his love to a spiritual love, divine. Here the love is being seen in a sense of God's love. It's a platonic. And the last line, but might I of Jove's nectar sup, I would not change for thine. Here Jove is a god. In these lines, poet is once again comparing the love of that lady to God's, what do you say, God's nectar. Nectar is here in Hindi, you can say Amrit. And Amrit, that is immortality. He is saying that if she expresses her love to him, if she directly say how much she loved to him, he would deny God's love even. He will not accept the God's love, not accept that nectar which God will even give him. He will deny that also. So he is very positive about her love. In this first stanza poem, poet is just showing how much deeply he is in love with that lady. That's all for today. Just go through it. Any doubt? Ask it. Thank you.